I think it's time to stop dividing Canadians, to stop pitting one part of the population against another. I can't help but notice with regret that both the tone and the policies of my government changed drastically on the eve and during the last election campaign. From a positive and unifying approach, a decision was made to wedge, to divide, and to stigmatize. I fear that this politicization of the pandemic risks undermining the public's trust in our public health institutions. This is not a risk we ought to be taking lightly. In this last year, Canada has reached one of the highest levels of vaccination in the world. It is something we should be proud of. It is something we should be celebrating. Yet here we are, more divided than ever. It's time to stop with the division and the distractions. It's time to choose positive, not coercive methods. It's time to unite. But I have to admit that I've been uncomfortable with the politicization of the pandemic and of vaccination during the last election campaign. One thing that worries me is that as people perceive this politicization of the pandemic that we've observed over the course of the last couple of months since the election, there's a real risk that people will eventually lose trust in public health institutions, and that worries me a lot. So that's part of why I'm here today, and I can quote just Cyril Cohen, who's a professor at Bar-Ilan University in Tel Aviv and one of the senior advisors to the Israeli government's Committee on Vaccination, who said quite eloquently, when you mix epidemiology and politics, what you get is politics. And I think we have at this point to remove politics from the pandemic, work together and focus on what unites us. We're one of the most vaccinated country in the world. I think it's time to take a more positive approach. And that's essentially my message today.